now listening to Hoodcast AF, the bad boys of action figure podcasting. Join Jonathan Fallen and Papa Dad as they shit talk some action figure related shit. Be warned that the ideas and opinions expressed are nothing more than entertainment. So fuck off and enjoy. Hoodcast begins. Now.
Welcome to Hoodcast and episode 211, which marks a special event, I guess. It's 211, and that brings me back to my 211 days, you know, drinking that Steel Reserve. You ever dabble in that?
Oh, yeah, bro. Especially when it first came out. I think it might have been 1998.
That's when they first came out?
Yeah, 98, dude, because I've either 98 or 97. I know I was living in Sacramento.
Because that's when I was drinking.
I remember they were like, for a 40 ounce, it was like $1.49 or something like that.
Yeah.
And then the Deuce Deuce was like 89 cents or some shit. And they came in those big mouth 40 ounce bottles.
Yeah.
And man, did that shit taste disgusting.
It's like they have some sort of sweet flavor to it that's just, oh, and especially when it gets warm. Like, if it's not ice cold and you start tasting it, you're like, it just makes you want to vomit. Like,
yeah, it's always that first couple that got swallows that are the worst.
Yeah,
like,
then you get used to it.
Why am I drinking this?
Your second one.
Yeah, but I used to be broke. I'll be penny pinching back then, especially in Sacramento. So I was buying like three of those 40s for like under $5 or something, whatever it was.
Yeah.
And go home and get fucked up. But I had to drink it with lime and salt.
Oh, but it's like sweet,
like I pour it in a cup.
Yeah.
I pour it in a big cup and then put lime and salt in it.
But it has that sweet flavor. I guess people eat margaritas that way.
Ugh, bro.
Oh man!
And especially boy, does it get you ever some drunk.
When you get to that bottom of the 40, though, and it's that shit's the fucking worst. There used to be like this zombie. I called him Zombie Tom. He was this dude who like wore a suit every day, but he was smelly and disgusting, and he had mental problems, so he could barely even talk. He just walked around like a zombie.
Yeah.
We go, hey, Zombie Tom, go in Fooverless and buy me a fucking Steel Reserve. You know, or a country club, because, they were like $1.29, you know? And then one of us would go in with them, because he wasn't allowed in stores, because he's a fucking raging alcoholic, and, you know.
Right.
And then, he'd come out with, like, a couple of Steel Reserves for us. All right, Zombie Tom, see you later.
I can't believe you mentioned that. Country, what was it? Country Club.
Country Club, you remember that?
Those 40s were shit, too,
they
bro.
They were shit, dude. Oh, yeah, I drank the shit out of Country Club, though.
I can't believe you.
Why are they like the shittiest beards named after like, you know, nice
American
beards.
Shit, right?
Like a country club, you know, like it sounds like you're going to be
Steel Reserve
shit out of a champagne glass. Nah.
Right.
And how is it a reserve? It's like they made this shit hella years ago and they have a stockpile of like 30 million beers. Like
I know why it's a reserve, cuz it's reserved for broke ninjas.
Yeah.
We don't keep this over here with y'all. It's the reserve.
Yeah.
We reserve this for you.
Yeah, your only price to get into the country club is $1.29.
It's $1.29 for the ounce.
Yeah. And then you chill and hang with the homies. And don't forget to pour your first sip out for the dead homies.
Right. Before we moved to Sac, I don't think I was 21. I was still living with Marina and at her dad's house. Her dad was cool. Like I could ask him. I'd be like, "Hey, Jose, can you take me to the store and buy me some beer?" And he would take me to like we had this grocery store. It was called Russell's. It was like kind of a local, like a Piggly Wiggly or some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? And I would get that's where I would get some the cheap beer too. But I would drink Mickey's a lot back then.
Yeah, I did too. Like especially the grenades, they were always fun.
Yeah, Mickey's that was actually palatable.
Yeah, no, I can still drink Mickey's. And it's fun to, like, you take off the caps and you try to, like, read what it
says. Yeah, solve the little puzzle.
And you're drunk as shit. And then, like, later on the day, or night, depending on when you're drinking, somebody gets it and they go, yeah, nah, that ain't it. That's too fucking easy. Right.
They're like, see the box, and then the arrow pointing at the top of the box means out of the box, nah. And then the ball rolling down the hill means ball rolling downhill, and then you got out of the box bowling it down the hill.
That's it, dude. I remember when Steel Reserve came out with like a blackberry flavor. And, dude, it was so fucking sweet and gross. I drank the whole can, and then I shat green. It was crazy, dude. And it was like, it was purple liquid. You know, like, I guess there's green food coloring in that somehow, or green and red, whatever makes purple, blue and red. Yeah, I don't know how I shat green.
You ever drink Thunderbird?
Yeah. Thunderbird, that's gross,
too.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, fuck.
And Mad Dog 2020.
Oh, yeah, I used to drink the shit out of MD. Mogan Dugans or whatever the fuck it is.
What? Hey, remember that one beer, Red Dog?
Red Dog. I know the brewery Red Dog.
It was like, it had like a fucking...
like a pit bull on like it or something?
Bull, yeah, like a pit bull on it, yeah. That shit came out and then it got really cheap too.
I used to drink that Ice House shit too. And then like...
Ice Reserve?
I think it was just called Ice House and I called it
Ice House. Yeah, Ice House, yeah.
Because it was
then everything went ice for a minute.
Everything.
But ice.
And it was like all high alcohol percentage because it was ice. Yeah. Beer, you know?
Mickey Ice.
Natty Ice. All the Natty ice beers.
The ice way.
That reminds me, though, like I've never been, because San Diego Comic-Con's coming up, and I've never been to it. I've been to a lot of other conventions not as big, like WizardCon and shit, where they do have celebrities and panels and... You know, but nothing like San Diego Comic-Con. And I wonder, people who go there and who aren't sellers, because sellers could probably just bring a cooler and shit and drink their own shit. How do people go walk around and just, like, drink their stuff? You get a hotel room right near it or something? Or, like, that just sounds all super expensive to me, you know?
Yeah.
And especially just to go stand in line to fucking talk to people or something or buy a figure. It just, I don't know.
To stare at the back of somebody else's head for an hour?
I better be drinking. And I don't care what it is. Get me a Steel Reserve. Just bring me back. Nah, I don't want that because it's going to get warm in my fucking hands. I'm going to vomit in the line.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to smell like shitty beer.
The thing with 40s, even if you put them in the fridge and let them get nice and cold, it's a 40. You're holding it.
Right.
Within 5 to 10 minutes, that shit's room temperature.
Yep. And it's gross as fuck. You got to bring one of those chilled mugs.
Only the shit beer comes in. And only shit beer. Well, Budweiser, of course, has 40s, but basically only shit beer comes in 40 ounces.
Who invented the 40 ounce? That's a good one, because
Ice Cube.
When do you need like 40 ounces of beer in just one sitting? I mean, I do.
Wait, Eazy-E didn't invent 40s?
What? He went to the beer company and said, you guys should make 40 ounces instead of these little 32 ounces.
I always thought rappers made 40 ounces.
I don't think so. I think they were just around and they rapped about them. How are these like poor ass rappers who they ain't making a lot of money invent 40 ounces?
Well, all I know is when I was a young gentleman, like in the eighth grade, me and my homies, my one homie, we wanted to be hard so bad, and we were big fans of NWA and all that good shit. We did everything we could to get some 40s, and I think our first 40s, the first 40 I ever drank, was a St. Ides.
Okay.
And
yeah.
Boy, did I get some drunk. And then you were like, I drank a whole 40, bruh, to the head.
You save it and put it in your room as a badge of honor.
Later, and you got all these 40 bottles.
Later, you pee in it and then you take a picture of yourself. You're like, look, I got a whole nother 40.
Or you get drunk and you try to like peel the label off perfectly.
Oh, yeah. That's when nobody's talking enough and you're sitting there peeling the fucking 40 label. The goal here is just to get drunk. But there's nothing else to do, so you start inventing drunk games, you know?
Right.
Like knocking over beer cans with rocks or something.
Right.
And then it ends up, oh, you're fucking cheating. You're over the fucking line.
Market 8, dude.
And then someone drops their 40 and they're like, oh, give me some of yours. You're like, fuck you, dude.
Fuck no. We all, these shits cost $2 a pop.
But who was saying that, like, dude, we should plan, like, something for for San Diego Comic Con like next year or something, like to go.
Toy Art.
Toy Art Unlimited, yeah. Yeah. That'd be cool, dude, if we could just like
I would be
get some cool spot.
You notice these East Coast fuckers, they all get together at the at those cons and shit. We don't do shit out here on the West Coast.
But they're they could take trains and shit. Out here on the West Coast, it's like a bunch of desert and all terrain and all kinds of shit you gotta drive through. You know?
Right.
Like, and it's super, it's way more expensive, I'm sure.
California travel, you think?
Yeah, like, all the East Coast, like, states are all close together.
Yeah.
So they have the ability to do that shit. And they can just take a train.
I'm down to go to San Diego Comic Con, but I'm flying. I don't want to drive no 10 hours. Fuck that shit.
It's not, oh, yeah. It's not 10. It's probably like 8.
It's 10 hours, dude.
I guess through traffic through L.A., yeah.
Yeah. Once you... It's about 5-6 hours smooth sailing, and then you get into
L.A., yeah.
Montana and all that old shit.
Once you go over the Grapevine. And then all of a sudden,
yeah, all of a sudden, the fucking 20-minute drive takes 2 hours. I always hated that about going to my homeboy's house in Fontana, because you make good time, 4 hours, 5 hours, and then you're like there, and then that last just 20 miles is like an hour, and you're like,
yep.
Bro, come on.
Everything beyond Magic Mountain. I was doing 90 the
whole way.
But I don't even think...
What about when you drive through Kalinga? Kaminga? Kalinga.
Conolingus.
You know what I'm talking about? When you're going to L.A. That town Kalinga and it smells like cow? Shit.
Oh, yeah. That's where...
For like Harris, 3 or 4 miles.
The Harris Cow Ranch or whatever it is and shit.
Yeah, that's right.
And you see all them cows just packed in there and it just stinks.
Yeah.
I've stayed at like that hotel before, though, too.
Is it worse when you go through that area to have your windows up or down?
I don't know. I've tested both. But when you're right at the cows, you don't smell them no more. When you get away from them, you start smelling
it
them.
It lingers. Yeah. I noticed windows down seems to work a little bit better for me.
It could. I don't know.
Because I feel like... The air is coming through the vents with the windows up.
It ain't filtering nothing.
And just marinating and like I'm breathing in shit. While, I don't know, I guess windows down gives me at least a breeze going through some oscillation.
Well, before we get to the news, let's play a commercial from our sponsor, Steel Reserve. 211. Remember this episode, right. 211. All right.
Steel. Here at the home of America's pastime beer, Steel Reserve, we take pride in our handcrafted lager. It's slow brewed for its exceptionally smooth flavor, which makes each taste an experience. Now, whether you remember it or not, Steel Reserve here sits at an 8.1% alcohol content,
which can only
benefit you. Here at Steel Reserve, we believe that health regulations and FDA guidelines are just that, guidelines. But what I'm really here to let you know is that every time you take a sip of a lukewarm Steel Reserve, part of us is in you.
Yuck.
Steel Reserve is known for its acute ability to make even the ragiest of alcoholics black out. Don't believe me? Check out our brewmaster currently tilling the fields.
He's passed down the tractor.
We pride ourselves on being one of the only beers that needs a bold chaser. Wow. We use extra malted barley and select hops for extra gravity. Imagine what our unique flavor would be like without the gravity.
Dude's taking a shit in the fields. Fields of barley.
Steel Reserve is bottled at the source in our own self-sustainable bottling plant and is brewed exclusively at a refreshing room temperature. Steel Reserve is always bottled directly from the source. Just don't ask what the source is.
Right.
So next time you find yourself at a dirty gas station with a couple of bucks and some change, make sure to pick up 40 ounces of pure awfulness. Now that's a golden shower I wouldn't mind.
And with that, let's get to the news.
Join the Hoodcast AF Patreon for bonus media and episodes. It's cheaper than the garbage you buy on a daily basis. Cheaper than a dollar a week, you could have access to tons of bonus episodes and content. For only $3 a month, you will be indoctrinated into the Hoodcast Cult Collective. And now the action figure news.
You know, and also speaking of the Patreon, the a new episode of Tales from the Toy Box, which used to be a segment on the show, and maybe it still will be, but there's an episode titled exactly that. And Toystradamus makes a guest appearance and tells me of the future, which gets kind of annoying, but also hilarious. So check it out on the Patreon. Become a subscriber to one of the tiers. There's a dollar tier. There's $3 tiers. There's t-shirt tiers. There's sweater tiers. Just get on there and check it out. This week in the news. First up, the Todd Father, Mac Daddy himself, McFarlane. So we got a first look at Fusion, which is from the Batman Superman. What is it? World's Finest.
Flash.
World's Finest, I think it is. It's like an amalgamate of both of them. I don't know the story behind this character, but
I think it's actually three characters.
Is it?
Yeah, I think it's Green Lantern and Batman and Superman.
Okay, I don't care. He looks stupid.
I don't either.
Yeah, it's to me, it just looks like another Batman who's painted.
I never read that DC crap, and I probably never will because. A lot of that old... I don't read a bunch of shit. I just read... The only DC I read is just Batman. Yeah. So you won't catch me reading The Flash and this and that and this. And none of that... The only crossovers I did do was Death Metal and Metal, so...
You're just saying currently you don't... I mean, did you read any, like, the Jim Lee Supermans and stuff like that?
No.
Really? I got those books. No. They're pretty good. It's like two or three books.
To be honest, to keep it $1.50, the weekly habit's only been around for about 3 years.
Yeah.
And that's about how long I've been on a weekly.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
It all comes together like butt cheeks.
McFarlane also showed off some of his Marvel statues, you know, continuing, because he had the Spider-Man and all that stuff for the comic book covers. He showed off an Iron Man, which looks like all right, a Deadpool that looks like shit, and a Wolverine that looks pretty good. So they're hit or miss on these statues. What I guess it's cool that he's making Marvel statues. I mean, people wish they were 7-inch figures because, you know, people want 7-inch figures to go with their DC shit. But I'm sure there's a clause in his contract where he cannot make Marvel characters in a 7-inch form. There's got to be.
Right.
Because they don't want 7-inch scale, whatever McFarlane scale is, 1/10 scale, to be taken over the market. Because McFarlane's doing big business.
Everybody has to switch up their
shit, yeah. Yeah. you know, Disney owning Marvel and then licensing it to fucking Hasbro. I'm sure Hasbro doesn't like it at all that McFarlane's dipping his toes into, like, Marvel territory. But Disney's looking way to make up that loss from... fucking Star Wars losing $4 billion that, what's his name? The fucking head honcho said that Star Wars streaming lost $4 billion. And it's not just because of the Acolyte. It's from earlier shit, so.
Well, I mean, the Hasbro sees the, you know, the big bad wolf at the door.
Mm-hmm.
The big bad McFarlane. And if he can get his hands... into that Marvel action, they're done.
Done. Dude, and when their contract comes up again, I know that it was just renewed, Hasbro's was, you know, and that might, I don't know how long that lasts, another 5-10 years, I don't know.
Right.
But, yeah, McFarlane may be able to grab it if he can show some sort of, like, numbers, you know?
Yeah, and then we'd really have to sit and kiss the ring.
Oh, no shit, huh?
You come to me. On the day that I taken over Hasbro.
Now look,
not once have you even considered calling me Godfather.
He's the Todd Father, man. He's gonna die in his mayonnaise garden, dude. Like, it's just gonna happen.
With
you asked
mayonnaise
me,
is just eggs and oil, so maybe be a chicken coop.
You asked me what are these joints on their shoulders? And I said, they're butterfly joints. But you tell me that they don't work like butterfly joints. They're just useless, useless shit that plugs in with the ring around it. That's the best I can do for the give you this cheap shit and remake Batmans and Supermans all the time.
We'll save money by using, instead of butterfly joints, we'll use caterpillar joints.
I'm going to get my own shoulder surgery. And I told the doctor, nah, just put a fucking ring around it. I got shit to do.
The doctor said we can replace your arm, but it's just an old arm that we repainted.
Give me the arm of the Batman.
I want the arm of the Batman that I designed, specifically with the pointy shoulders.
This time, I want it glow in the dark, okay? Forget
and then
about
Joker
it.
Is it.
I don't want no Fugazi. Next up, Super 7. So they showed off some of their D&D Ultimate figures. This is not from the cartoon. This is like classic Dungeons & Dragons because it's got the old logo and shit. So they showed off Vecna, which is from D&D. It's not just from Stranger Things. It's old school, like first edition Dungeons & Dragons.
Yeah.
Vecna is like this evil wizard fucking zombie dude or lich or something like that. I don't fucking know what he actually is. But he looks pretty cool. Comes with like a sword and a book of the dead and all that shit, or spell book. They also showed off Tiamat, which is like the five-headed dragon. It looks like crap to me. And also Invisible Sheila, which is it's a translucent figure that looks stupid. So, yeah, but I'm sure there is like classic D&D nerds out there who probably going to eat this shit up. Maybe, maybe not, because what do you need it for? They're still playing D&D, but they're playing it on streaming, like we are talking right now. I even have coworkers who play D&D, and I didn't even know it because I used to play.
Wait, they just get together in a group chat and then they like.
Yeah, they say
then,
like,
and
oh,
we all enter the tavern.
And yeah, and then what? You never play it. That's not. You don't just like play like that, dude. You don't know how to play. It's actually fun.
I'm glad.
It's fun. It's fun. It is. It grows your imagination, man. It's something to do besides being depressed and not drinking. Have a 211. No. That'll make
I
you
just
not
do
want
a 211.
Because you know, one night of drinking 211, you won't drink for days. Okay?
Right.
I think that's the medicine. But also with Super 7, they showed off Mikey's Pizza Party Wagon, which is a repainted version of the Turtle Wagon, sort of.
Yeah, it's all right.
It looks all right. And it's going to, I guess it's going to be there at Comic-Con. They only have so many made. But they also have the Ultimate Mikey that comes with it. I don't know if he comes with it. He's separate because he comes in a pizza box. And it's he's got the Pizza Time chef robe or chef apron. And he's got the chef's hat. Although I've never seen a pizza chef wear a hat like that. But right. I get it. It's kind of cartoony. And he's got like hands that hold the pizza. I kind of like it, you know. But too much turtle shit. I'm in turtle overload.
Bro. This is Chinese year of the turtle or something.
No shit.
They are like rah-rah-rah-rah-rah in us with all this turtles, dog.
Dude,
like,
turtles fucking everywhere, no matter where you look. Turtle this, turtle
and,
that.
Yeah, and it...
I can pull a turtle out of my fucking hat.
Am I wrong, or does it seem like toys seem to trend that way every about year and a half? Like, all of a sudden... Joe's is the shit. Like, everybody wants Joe's.
Yeah.
And everybody's dropping Joe's. And then it'll switch over to Transformers. You get what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I think right now is a big turtle push. Everything is turtles.
Everyone's pushing turtles, you know, trying to make turtle babies and shit.
Right. You know, earlier today, my son was in the bathroom and I was like, hurry up. I got to get in there. I got a turtle head poking out.
You got to push out a turtle, dude. He's got to get to his home. All he needs is some mutagen. He's going to come back and go, Father! Father!
Yeah. And then, like, then I could train him. It'd be a shit turtle.
Dude, teenage mutant.
A shirtle.
A shirtle.
Yeah.
In a half shell.
gonna have to, yeah.
With corn. I don't know why you're eating so much corn.
No, I feed my turtle corn.
Oh, okay.
And then it shits out corn.
There used to be like this restaurant in kind of Vallejo. It's called Palby's. And like they had like a glassed off wall in an outside area that they just had a bunch of like animals they could own, like turtles and shit.
Right.
So I just go to see the turtles. The food was terrible.
Right.
I hated the food. It was like old people food for back then. And I would just look at the turtles and go, man, those turtles are fucking awesome. Do they do anything?
Right, right.
Because
well, you know,
the turtles were huge.
Sometimes if you eat the wrong food, your turtle will be a snapping turtle.
Okay. Yeah, you don't want that. So
you drop the turtle and it comes up and it jumps up and bites you on the ass again.
Dude, if you want a colored turtle, like, you got to get a flavored 211. Like, I think they had more flavors than blackberry. They had like a blue one, I think, and a red one.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
And I think they still make them.
Or green turtle.
You know how like chip flavors, they make all these crazy beers doing that too, especially 211, right. Man. They're trying to get people back on, you know, the 211 game. Like, it used to be cool, I guess. I don't
know. They're like, you know what? This new millennial generation, their livers are good.
Yeah.
We need to start targeting them, yeah.
Right, with like sweet, like interesting flavors.
Yeah.
Like
a scripture.
Mango 211. Strawberry mango 211. Yes.
Wild passion.
Yes, and I will also put beard oil in my neck beard and drink this 211. Right. But I will sip it from a nice cup so you don't see the logo of the Steel Reserve. But yeah, also with that release, they have a glow-in-the-dark scumbag. So we all know how Super 7's glow-in-the-dark figures sell. They'll be on discount on Amazon.
Oh, yeah. Those are winners.
Also in the news, this is just Ghostbusters news. But so I guess a long time ago, Blitzway made a 1/6 scale Ecto-1, you know, the Ghostbusters car with lights and sounds and everything like that. Meant for 1/6 scale figures, like Hot Toys type of shit. And so this funeral parlor in Arkansas thought, hey, let's turn these things into fucking cases to bury your loved ones in or keep your loved ones' ashes in. And so they did. They added a compartment where you can, like, put your loved ones in the fucking Ecto-1, which is crazy. Like, so you have to pay the price of a Hot Toy style fucking Ecto-1 plus the price of it carrying your loved one's ashes, which is already expensive, you know?
Sir, this is the most affordable receptacle we have.
Wait, does the Blitzway come out of the box? I want it in the box so I can keep it mint condition. But how are you going to get your ashes, your loved one's ashes in there? Nah, I don't fucking care.
Just like the boys at One Eye Island. Lord, you took sweet Prince Donnie from us. Yeah. Does everything gotta be fucking Vietnam with you?
Lord, it was like that one time when you took sweet Ray from us and we were battling the great Marshmallow State Puff Man. God damn it, Walter. Does everything's gotta be fucking Ghostbusters with you?
Right.
Dude, I'm sorry, dude.
Fuck it, let's go bowling.
It's the fucking ashes all over. Next up, NECA. So, this is just brand new news. NECA, they did a smart thing. They are re-releasing their Beetlejuice Cult Classics figures. So, limited articulation. There's the Beetlejuice and the striped gear that we all know. And also the his kind of suit wedding gear. I think it's his wedding gear, yeah. The red suit. And limited articulation.
That seems like more purple.
Yeah, or purple. Yeah, whatever it is. Yeah, we know what it is. Yeah. We've all seen the movie 1,000 times.
Yeah, you look like
but these are going to be released, you know, next year at some point. Probably during when the new Beetlejuice film comes out. So out of all these years, everyone's saying, NECA, re-release these figures or make an ultimate version. They're like, nah, fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Pay me. Fuck you. Pay me. Oh, and also, we're going to release these now or tell you about them now. And we're not doing anything new to them except for the packaging. And yeah, fuck you. Pay me. You're going to buy them because everyone's going to be juiced because the movie's out.
The movie's out. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's well, smart.
Until people watch it. I mean, it's going to suck.
It's not going to be as good. It's going to be fine.
It's going to suck. Tell me the last time they either redid something or did a sequel to something that's actually been good, bro.
Texas Chainsaw Massacre?
Cool. Okay, that's good. But let's go down the list of not good. The Ghostbusters.
They're all right.
Bill and Ted.
Bill and Ted was great.
The new Bill and Ted?
Yeah, I liked it. It's hella funny.
Jay and Silent Bob again. That was terrible.
They were all terrible.
All this shit is just whack, bro.
Nah, I don't think so, man. People want it. I think.
How much you want to bet that Beetlejuice, the second one, sucks?
It's still Tim Burton. Not that Tim Burton's great or anything, because he hasn't done anything great in a long time.
Just from the preview, I was like, this is. Crap.
It looks whack to me. I'm gonna side with you for a second because I do think it looks whack too. I think they're just trying to like shoot some shit out there and like, yeah, they're trying to make it good, but it's gonna feel too polished and everything. Not the CG. I know they're not using a whole lot of CG. They're gonna use some, but the sandworms are all like stop motion and stuff, but whatever, that doesn't make for a good film. It just adds, you know, a little technique.
Right.
To
the
it.
Reason Beetlejuice was dope is because there wasn't a Beetlejuice at the time. And then that movie came out and did something new and cool. And it was quirky. And the actors were perfectly fucking casted. And
yes.
It was good. Babes. There wasn't a bunch of CGI at the time. Tim Burton's shit was fresh. No, but, you know. And now, 30 years later, everybody's already seen it and been there, done that.
Will there be an F-word in it?
How is Beetlejuice even relevant now?
Do you think they will even drop...
watching the original one.
They're not going to even drop an F-bomb. He's nice fucking model. It ain't going to happen.
Yeah.
There ain't going to be no F-bomb. He's not going to be looking up people's skirts.
He ain't going to be doing a shimmy, going to a whorehouse.
No.
He ain't going to comb his hair like, you know where a guy like me can get a little action.
You know, he's not going to take a stick and look up a girl's dress. He's just not.
Right.
He ain't going to do any of that. He's not going to grab his stick and honk honk.
While he reaches back and tries to spill on the other girl's, the girl's fucking choncha.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
This shit ain't happening in the new one.
Come on, bro. He's not going to be like, chewing a dog.
Yeah, this movie's going to be all about women empowerment. You know it is. Because... this is all the commercials that they pump into us. Like, there's commercials of old men who are silver age foxes who use dye for their hair more silver. And then their black wife complains and goes, "Oh, you don't know how to wash dishes. I got the secret ingredient, you know." And she has that smart look on her face, you know.
Right.
And it's like, dude, what? This doesn't look like real life to me. I'm not saying it can't happen. I'm just saying every commercial's that way, where the dude's the idiot and the woman's the smartest person of all fucking time. Right. And I'm not saying that's not possible. I'm saying in few instances, it's okay. Look, y'all hit me on the wrong mark here. You're not hearing me. I'm just saying that the way they market shit to us, like it's real, it's only to please 1%ers. I'm getting too.
Well, they try to sell you a dream, so that you bite on the product. You know, like you get what I'm saying. Like fucking with us is gonna make this is how life is better. You know, but don't buy Ajax, buy Comet.
Dude, my wife said to me the other day, "Why are you sitting like that?" And I go, "Sitting like what?" And she goes, "You're man spreading." I'm like, "Do not put man in front of anything and create a word for me. I hate that shit." I'm like, "Look, this is the way normal dudes sit. I'm not trying to chauvinize anything. I'm watching TV. Like, I'm not like, hey, look at my junk. There's nothing hanging out. That's just how dudes sit. We can't change that. You know, I'm not purposely crossing my legs hella tightly trying to, you know, feminize myself. I'm not aware of that shit, you know? Like, don't man spread me.
And especially now that it's been hot out here, you gotta let the balls have some circulation. Bro.
Otherwise, they stick, dude. And I don't got no ball stick. I don't even use deodorant. Barely. I don't, because I don't smell bad, man. I use it like maybe on hot days or hot times. I'll use it once a week.
I can't use ball stick. I have to have the aerosol.
Ah, that's good stuff. I use the powder shit. That's what I use. Like Gold Bond and shit. Like Shaquille O'Neal. And he's like rubbing his hands together. Yeah.
You know, when you need the ice for the pain and then the hot for the cold. Ice are hot.
Right? And his best friend, the general. Yeah. You know they hang out a lot. Shaq's got a lot of friends.
All you need is a slice of Kobe pizza. And you could be great like Shaq.
I like Kazam. Also with NECA, they shut off some Toonie Classics. These are 6-inch Bert and Ernie. Now, these are all the Toonie Classics where they're not posable. So Bert has his arms, you know, folded, and he looks annoyed, like, you know, he's annoyed at his his gay boyfriend, Ernie, who's, like, snickering with his arms out. Pretty typical. But, yeah, okay, Bert and Ernie. Somebody's going to buy them.
I guess.
I mean... Yeah, I guess. I'm not. But look, I grew up watching Sesame Street, but I don't need Bert and Ernie. I just don't. Unless I think of a picture idea and make them hella gay. Because that's what they need to be. Didn't they already confirm that they're gay?
No.
I thought they did. Not like they made out.
Gay, bro.
They live together in a house for hella years. And they take baths.
Yeah, but...
They play hide the rubber ducky.
Yeah, but they never, like, have any... They're, like, ambiguously gay.
The ambiguously gay duo.
Yeah. That's the only reason I know that word.
They don't know that they're gay yet.
They don't never reference, like, anything sexual. So why put sexuality on
them? Because in this day and age, I'm trained not to manspread. And right now I'm mansplaining. But this is for a reason, because I'm into identity politics, because I have to be. So everyone needs an identity for their gender or something. Or their, what does Bert and Ernie identify as? We know.
Puppets.
Ooh, Muppets. Yeah, I'm into Muppets.
Yeah.
Not creepy.
They're guys with hands up their asses.
Yeah. It could be something else if you get lucky. Also with NECA, they showed off their Mirage Turtles will now be single-packed. So you can find them instead of the exclusive four-pack that a lot of people... It was floating around a long time. But also, they showed off their Last Ronin accessory pack, which comes with that one robot, two robot dogs, extra head, a bunch of good shit for, like, if you read the Last Ronin series...
Yeah.
Pretty cool accessory pack. And then also they showed off, this is like a shirtle. It's like a nude Last Ronin that comes with like battle damage arms and heads. But he's naked. He's super nude, just like in the comic.
Yep.
You see his little turtle tail?
He's got a turtle head popping out.
He never pops out of the shell, which I don't think turtles can.
No, they're connected to it.
Oh, so it's not like Looney Tunes.
No.
Do you ever think that as a kid, and then you know like a friend who has a turtle, and you're like, make him come out. I can't pull him out. Oh, shit, that sounds...
I'm like, dude, hide this joint in your turtle shell. My mom's coming.
Bro, hide this whole 211 in your turtle shell.
Or like turtles are like hermit crabs, and they can go into it, like...
Oh, yeah, see?
And go into a... 40 bottle and make that its shell.
You know? Dude, and see? Yeah, throwing beers into the ocean is safe. You're making homes.
Right. The last hobo.
Also, next up, Star Wars! So I guess the HasLab back the bar has made it, and they're on their way to Guido. I don't think it'll get us... It might... Isn't it only has like a couple days left, right?
I'm not sure how many days. I haven't been paying attention to that bullshit.
So it won't get up to the Wolfman. I mean, I didn't back it, but the only thing I want is that Wolfman. But I want him in, like, 6-inch version. I just like how, like, cheesy he looks.
Right.
And plus, like, he was my favorite while watching Star Wars in the cantina scene. Everyone has a favorite alien in there, you know?
Yeah.
From, like,
your... I like the pick with the 6-inch... Oh, wait, that's Jabba's Palace.
That's Jabba's Palace. That's different.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. She's a big-ass bitch, man. I have her in, like, one of the, you know, TVC scale forms. Not TVC, but one of the early ones.
That's tons of fun.
I took a picture of, like, Boba Fett riding her instead of the Rancor.
Rancor?
Yeah. He was riding on her shoulders, just to be clear.
Right.
They also showed off their Halloween-style two-pack. The Inquisitor, who looks like Dracula, and what's his name? Duras, he's a bounty hunter or whatever, as Frankenstein, kind of.
I haven't seen that.
It's a two-pack.
It's a what scale is that now?
6-scale. Those are the only ones that they do, like, the Halloween kind of paint jobs and Christmas paint jobs. These look the worst, though. These look fucking awful. They're just terrible. Nobody's going to buy this shit. And it's going to be super cheap, like, eventually. They're just garbage, man. Every company trying to, like, make some sort of, like, reason to re-release their same fucking figures that nobody bought anyways. You know, maybe they bought one. And most people didn't buy anyone because nobody really needed the Inquisitor or the fucking this bounty hunter dude. I don't know.
Which Inquisitor is it?
The main one.
The Grand Inquisitor?
Yeah. And then they, like, paint, like, some Dracula, like, hairline on them, and it just looks stupid. It's one of the dumbest ones. Next up, Mondo. So for San Diego Comic-Con, one of their exclusives is a Masters of the Universe Scareglow, like, in the classic style. But this time, it's their soft vinyl figures. So they're roughly, I think, 8 or 9 inches. And this one, though, like, his body is kind of see-through, but it has, like, this cherry blossom glow to it. But you can see his bones inside. It's really cool looking, man. I really like it. Not that I would pick it up, though, but it would be a cool display piece if you lit it properly, because, like, all the see-through, like, plastic that they do that...
This thing's huge, though.
How big is it?
It's fucking huge.
It's fucking huge. Never heard of
it. 15 inch.
Oh, 15 inches.
Yeah.
It's a lot bigger than me.
Yeah. I'd hope so. You could split your wife in half.
Oh, dude, I'd have problems, man. How do you think I'd pack that shit in? I can't. Like, I'd be at work like, oh, shit, my dick fell out. Sorry, bro. Although I work in
hazardous. You wear a helmet on that thing.
I work in hazardous environments, so it'd be like, oh, shit. Ow. My dick fell on the hot pipe or something. Ooh, the hot pipes fell on the hot pipe. It went ting. It ain't no soft vinyl figure. I mean, it is at first.
It comes with cloth goods.
It's a my hard drawer. Vinyl.
Yeah.
Plushy.
My dick's more like a bobblehead pop.
I think we covered everything for news.
All
right. I like when it comes around San Diego Comic-Con because news gets less and less and less, you know, because
it's all about just that one. Yeah.
And then Comic-Con hits and it's like, fuck all these new releases that they showed off, like that are coming out the next year or so. And you're like, I gotta get some of this stuff and that stuff. The exclusives I don't really care about. Not this year. I'm not like, oh shit, I gotta get them.
I haven't seen anything really that I was like, whoa, bro.
Yeah. Me neither. No standing in line for me. I would just stand out in front and go, hey, you got an extra pass with my, and I'd be holding my 211. Let's get to recent acquisitions. I think a discount, girl, you gonna give it to me. Walmart employee, Target team member. Give me that shit, give me your phone number. Call me later when it's in stock, yo. Got that Casey Raff 2-pack. Gonna sell it to you out the motherfucking back. Cause you hood cast for life. Gonna be there. Gonna take it real time. Recent acquisitions, what we picked up this week or last week because it was cut out. What'd you get this or last week, Cobra?
Nothing both weeks, man.
Whoa.
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Yep. Smart. You're so, so smart.
I just watched that movie recently, too. It still holds up, man. It's great every time I watch it. It's a, that
What's that, clip. 16 Candles?
No, well, it's that dude. Nah, it's not the same dude. It's a different dude. They look alike. They both, you know, rah-rah-rah-rah-rah.
That's not Dong Dick Dong or whatever?
Long Dick Dong?
Yeah.
Which is a hilarious name. Dude. You know he doesn't, right?
What, have a long dick dong?
Can't. It's like the,
nah, he totally has a long dick dong.
Yeah, but like...
It's legendary.
Molly Ringwald didn't fuck it with him.
Yeah, but... Because he's Asian, long dick dong just means he's average American size.
Ah.
His American penis is so,
so huge. Yes.
Great, the big American penis.
Oh, he's also so smart with the big penis.
Very thick with veins. Bulbous ahead. Most honorable penis.
Most honorable. Make a strong friendship last hours.
Your ancestor must have a great bigger penis too.
Yeah. You seen your daddy's dong in the shower. Yes. You grow big and strong like big man. Yeah, yeah, okay, okay.
Daddy penis a swinger back and forth.
You like big daddy.
Yeah. Asian penis are like R2-D2. Little round little head spinning around and around.
Beep boop.
Beep boop beep.
Beep. Yes. Asian penis like droid shutting down.
Beep. Asian penis look like an egg in nest.
But very wise. But only wise to strong American who is big penis and eat a hamburger. And a hot dog.
Eat a hot dog.
And a strong president who strong in mind like Joe Biden.
American president very sleepy.
Which mean he wise and strong cause he dream constantly. We are the music makers and we are the dreamers of dreams. Don't think that we're hating on Asians. We make fun of everyone equally. And if you were listening, we were making fun of Americans, okay? Because Asians, I mean, they're so smart. They know.
It was funny and not racial until you go, till you say that type of shit. Like, oh, we hate it, you know?
I get it.
That's like saying you got a black friend.
Are you saying that I don't?
American have a lot of Barack friends.
So not
so
racist
many
Americans.
Black men in America.
With a bigger penis.
With an even bigger penis.
Yes, you like...
Black penis is among us.
Oh, most American, white American like their black friend to cuckold their wife. Because a small white American penis. They learn all their American traits from Pornhub. If you look up China's recent searches, yeah, you'll know.
Right.
Well, anyways, speaking of Asian countries, I've been going to AliExpress a lot because, dude, dirt cheap figures, some knockoffs and some not. Like, I picked up the premium DNA Earthworm Jim figure. Dude, this shit's legit. It's the real deal. It's the real deal, dude. And $20.
Really?
And then I got the extra head pack for $16. And dude, the box is legit. Full tape and everything. Like, comes with the cover sleeve. Like, it's like they just... The factory just made more and is selling them on their own, you know?
Right.
And like, the heads are fucking dope, dude. They're
right.
No mispaints or nothing.
Ah, stupid American dog buy anything
I also picked up, like, it said NECA Deadpool. So I was like, the only ones they made that NECA made was the quarter scale shit. And it was $30. So I'm like, all right, I'll just buy it to see what it is. Turns out it's the exact replica of the quarter scale Deadpool with, you know, the massless head, the hat that says so cool, and the bling bling necklace and all that shit. But
really?
It's like a 6.5 inch version. Dude, it's dope. Like, that's the NECA didn't make that, but it's like you could tell it's probably the same molds, just dumbed down, you know, and made smaller. Right. And it comes in its own box and shit. Like, I've never seen this before. I don't know if some other company made it based off the NECA one, you know, like some indie shit. I don't know. But very cool. Like, I wonder if AliExpress is going to, like, blow up and all these figure company or figure hunters and shit are going to start buying shit from AliExpress and, you know, ruin it for everybody.
Right. All the prices go up.
But I see it, dude, like, even on Facebook, like, there's, like, ads for, like, squirt guns that look like lasers and shit like that. And they want, like, $50 for them, you know, if you click the link. And you go to AliExpress, they're, like, $19, you know? I just type in a similar name, like, oh, they're right there. $19. No, free shipping. I also picked up the Marvel Legends classic card Tombstone. Only because I didn't want Tombstone, but Tombstone's kind of a big dude. So the suit itself is nice. Pinstripe suit with the blue undershirt. It would look real good with a Vince McMahon head on it. You know, so I did that and it looks fucking phenomenal. So,
oh, medic and wrestler have no chance in hell.
No chance. That's what they got. That's it for recent acquisitions. Let's move on to coming up with the gang. We come not with the gang. We come not with the gang. We come not with the gang. We coming 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 not with the gang. Not with the gang. We coming not with the gang. We coming not with the gang. We coming not with the gang. Is what they do worthwhile? And now,
come on,
President Putin. Oh, I mean, Zelensky, or my vice president.
Come on, man.
Trump. I don't know what I'm doing. I didn't go to bed at 8. I don't know what you're talking about. I take a test, I can read a teleprompter, and I can wander off.
In America, when you want to get something done, you gotta... No, never mind.
What I'm trying to say is, listen up, Jack. To me, what I'm trying to say is, I don't know. Who's your man?
First of all, I'd like to address everybody that came this year today, and then also when I was a kid, you know, and then there was a guy in my neighborhood. And I told him, "Look here, Jack.
I feel your pain because one time I had to pee in a bottle, and then when I peed in it, I didn't remember where I was going. Over there. There's a word, and it's called production."
In today's economy, we see a lot of my son and a lot of cocaine.
Don't forget to join the Patreon and also go to hoodcastaf.com. And on the right side of the screen, there's a voice message button that will follow you all throughout it. Leave a voice message on Ask a Question, Play a Character. We're going to play it. So this first call is from the Pot Dog. Let's see what the Pot Dog is up to.
What's up, dudes?
What's
hey,
up?
It's the Pot Dog.
Oh, I
did an impression of the debate before I knew what the debate was. The debate was more fucked than I could have ever imagined. It was fucked.
Fucked.
And I like chaos. If I'm a D&D character, I'm picking like the chaotic neutral.
That's
so
what
I just watch the world burn, and I know that I have an out at the end. Because in my backyard, I have a time capsule, and if you dig it up, it's filled with a bunch of really, really good drugs from the past.
That's cool.
Called heroin.
I'd be digging that up tomorrow.
Yes, kids. You don't know the days of heroin, because all you know is the days of crazy fentanyl and danger. Yeah. But back in my day, you knew exactly what dangerous drugs were because it was named black tar heroin. And I thought one day the world's going to be so shit or I'm going to get cancer and I'm going to want to fucking take it out. But you want to take it out. You don't want to fucking dirty up your living room or your fucking tech room or, God forbid, your toy room with blood and brains from a blast like a Kurt Cobain shotgun. But jam! So, no, you don't want that.
You don't want your fingers smelling like heroin.
If you do that, put a fucking tarp or plastic, you fucking idiot. But no.
Tinfoil on your windows?
I'm not an advocate for any of that. He is an advocate for more humane shit. Like, I don't know, save your one heroin time for a for sure overdose when you're an old man.
Right. Yeah.
And you got cancer. You know, fuck it, man. Fuck it. But what if that fucks up your DMT dose when you die? Because what if that's like heaven, right? And you do your DMT dose when you die. But if you do too much heroin, what if that fucks with your DMT dose? And then you like go into like a fucking limbo hell. What if that's what limbo hell is? We really don't know. All we know is if you do a lot of drugs, it's pretty fucking sweet. And collect toys. But this was drugs. Hey, Pot Dogs out, boys. Peace.
Yeah, doing drugs, you got to have some sort of, you know, know-how and know when to stop. That's, you know, that's
Pot Dog
thing.
Has a really good fucking point because, like, you're all loaded. And, wow, what if, like, hospice is really ruining people passing, they're passing because when you pass, you get that DMT hit.
Yeah.
And then you go to the light. What if you're all dopamined up and shit and you don't, your body doesn't produce it?
Like you missed the bus? Like you're crisscross and you missed the bus? You missed the light?
Right.
I missed the bus. I'm bringing it back.
How?
I'm bringing it back. I'm going to start wearing my parkas backwards, my pants backwards.
Yeah. Warm it up, Chris. I'm about to.
That was so hard back when I was in grade school.
Bro, come on. They were the dopest rappers at the time.
Do you think they were doing drugs? Yeah.
Yeah, and they were getting their booty hole spanked up.
Yeah, wasn't that? Yeah, didn't one of them die? Commit suicide,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, Jermaine Dupri be spanking up them booties, man.
No Diddy. None taken.
None taken. You always say that.
Yeah, because, you know, I don't want to be involved.
I get it.
We got a call from Ted Daggett, the troll who lives over underneath the Vallejo Alfred Zamper Memorial Bridge. So you're from old Ted. Ted.
Hey, guys. How the fuck everybody doing there?
We're good.
All right.
This is fucking Ted Daggett. I'm not dead.
Okay.
Contrary to popular belief there.
I don't think you're popular.
Fucking, yeah, I had a pretty dark time there for a while there, fellas. Old Ted Daggett, I was having some real issues. And so I thought the best thing to do would be to jump off the bridge and end my miserable existence.
Well, you just end up underneath
but
the bridge again.
Turns out I just fell really, really far there and smacked right on top of the roof of my own fucking house, and it shattered into 100 pieces.
You got to build that shit again.
I did my spine, and I guess it kind of padded my fucking fall there because I've been in a coma for 6 months. But old Ted Daggett is still alive.
How do you know that? You went to a troll hospital.
I had a really hard time there, fellas, for a while. Living under that bridge, and had that one guy from that other podcast there was coming into my place at night and doing dirty stuff to me.
Yeah, I gotta pause you real quick. I'm pretty sure that was Zach from the other show, and I'm sure he was going in diddling you while you were in the coma. That because I don't know that from experience, but just go on with your coma.
I didn't really want to do it, but I had nowhere to go, so I couldn't get away from him there. And I had enough, and I fucking jumped off the bridge, yelling Hootcast. And, yes, so I've been in a coma. I'm alive. Send me some fucking Doritos and Pepsi. I'm back under the bridge.
It's on its way.
Back, get out.
I have it on popular belief, although he is not a popular character, that he is related to, you know, the Goonies dude. Yeah.
Hey, you guys.
Hey, you guys. That's him. Hey, you guys. Except for he yells Hoodcast. You know, it's not as popular as Hey, you guys.
Right.
But Hoodcast is also not on the popular circuit. We don't want to be. We're over here mansplaining and shit and manspreading. So, I also like, I wonder how these characters get or go on our Hoodcast website, hoodcastaf.com, and leave these voice messages, not about action figures or anything. Not that we had a whole stint about drinking beer and 211 at the beginning of the show, but, you know, still is an action figure show. Like, our lives aren't just action figures, it's everything else that has to do with it. But, yeah, somehow we get these miscreants and rejects and the walks of life I'm interested in. And I don't know if he's related, but we got a call from Bingo here. Sounds kind of similar, huh?
Huh.
Bingo.
Hey, Matt, listen. You're not listening to what I said.
Bingo, I can't
hear you. Baby.
Baby.
Okay. Mimosa.
What is going on?
Well, so anyway, this is your mother, champagne. oh, shit. Your mother was champagne.
Oh, yeah, he's day drinking, man.
Yeah, sit apple, don't fall from the tree, fellas.
All right, I think he's day drinking. He's having brunch somewhere because he's ordering champagnes and shit, right? Mimosas?
Mimosas.
That's what I do with my wife. We go day drinking, and you know when they have bottomless mimosas, it's fun. And you eat a little bit, yeah. So you don't get too drunk. But you know they call them brunch skags or skag hags. I don't know what they brunch skags. They just like go for the free drinks. It's not free, right. But you pay $14.99.
Right, and you can get from
10 a.m. till 2 p.m. You can just drink, yeah. You know, and that's what I do. Wait. He's not cheating on me with the fig wife. He's not out on brunch with the fig wife. That better not end up.
I don't know, man. I mean, he's no
fucking wife. Thank you. Come on over here. So that little fucking Bingo's lappy boy. boy. This fucking place. Oh, it's me, Bingo. I'm at the strip club. You told me to meet you at, and I'm going to get tossed out of here before long. You just all hurry up.
Okay. What did he say?
Fallen?
He said, Fallen, I'm going to eat this apple and then all
sit on my lappy poo?
Yeah, I heard that. And then the rest of it. It's kind of garbled, but yeah.
I think he was with the fig wife, bro.
Hold on.
If I had too many more long out of life, I sneeze. Oh, Bingo, you're gonna definitely. Lady, it's a butt. You don't stick it in my face if you don't want me to lick it. yeah, so if I can. Hurry up, Fallen. I don't think they like me that much here. And they definitely don't like Cobra because they got a picture of him up by the bar that says he's not allowed in there. Something about showing his little willy in public. Okay, I'm going to give you another 15 minutes.
Another 15 minutes, and then he gets cut off. Yeah, I cut it off, so yeah, we don't need another 15 minutes of that. Maybe on the Patreon, who knows? But yeah, dude, I can I help you?
We're home.
Okay.
We got you food.
Great job, thank you.
You're welcome. Guess what else we got you?
What?
Cinnabons.
I do love me some. Yeah. Look, I love the smell of Cinnabon in the mall, but I hate the mall. That's the thing.
Yeah, so now
I get Cinnabon at home.
Yeah. We got you some.
Hey, you didn't go to brunch with like a clown character recently, right?
Are you the clown?
No, it's not me. I'm pretty funny though.
What are you talking about?
Exactly. Okay, I'm a little suspicious now.
I don't know what you're talking. I'm lost. I have a
bingo. You didn't go to brunch with old Bingo?
Who? What?
Yeah.
That sounds exactly like someone who went to lunch with Bingo.
First of all, you can't detect the lie in my voice. I know your lie face.
I don't have a lie face, and I'm not mansplaining, and I'm not manspreading.
Yeah, you do.
Whatever, brunch gag.
Actually, sorry to interrupt, but I was going to ask if you wanted to do the boozy brunch at Luca tomorrow.
Boozy brunch?
Or, you know, like
is it free?
No, that would be nice.
Well, how's it boozy brunch?
Because you get drunk and listen to that.
It's all
the
you
band.
Can drink? The bands are too loud and they're obnoxious.
Okay, anyways, whatever. Finish your show.
I mean, maybe. Yeah, I'm down.
Okay. Love you.
Love you too, Bingo.
What?
Bingo lover.
What? Exactly.
Bingo lover.
I'm not calling you a clown.
I don't like this.
I mean,
you got a new thing going on.
No, it's not a new thing. No, you have a new thing going on.
Right.
I'm on to it. You're trying to get a little clown in you.
Yeah. She's like, I heard guys with big feet, you know.
Oh, dude. She gets mad at me because I go, my feet are uniquely shaped. Like, they look like, you know, man feet. They got angles and shit. You know, they look good. And she's like, your feet are the ugliest things I've ever seen. I'm like, really? Have you seen your feet? You don't even have toenails. Like, I don't even know why we pay like $60, $70 for you to get your fucking nails done, your toenails done, when, dude, like three of your toes barely have any nails. It's like a dot. Come on. Why are we paying for that shit? Like, if I went, I would never go. I don't like people touching my feet. Like, my nails are giant. You got to work on that shit, you know?
Oh, yeah. That's worth the money first.
Hell yeah. I used the dog groomer, like Dremel, like shake that shit down, dude. Put some lacquer over it, you know? We got another call from Mike Vannucci, you know, the owner of the store here in Vallejo, the adult store. I forget what it's called. Right. Secrets or some shit. I don't know. Wet Dreams is what it's called. Yeah. Mike, what's up?
Hey, how you guys doing? It's your boy Mike Vannucci from over here on Wild Dreams in Vallejo over there.
Wild Dreams.
Wet Dreams.
The fuck Wild you dreams. Guys doing there tonight? First of all, I'm calling you because what the fuck's up with COVID, Dad? Listen, it's been like fucking 3 months since you've been to the place there. I'm almost fucking completely out of dicks. I got no more fucking big dicks, no medium dicks. All I got is the fucking Cobra Dad model, those fucking pinky size dicks, and nobody but fucking juggalos want those. You know what I mean? Nobody
with juggalos want those? Well, you know, Cobra gets all his shit from AliExpress, which is, you know, they're made by Asians. So what they think is sizable is, we already talked about this. We were alluding to it earlier, you know. So you can.
We have to mold a big mold for American penis.
Yes. We have to take a Shaq model and size it down.
Shaq a size dick, tall as a Kevin Hart.
That's pretty fucking good.
Nobody's fucking buying those things. I need fucking things quick. I know you stopped your other job, but fucking A, man. You can't come by and hook a brother up with some penises or what, Dad? Fucking A. Second of all, Mr. fucking Jonathan Fallon.
Yo, what's up?
I got your fucking boy Bingo over here. He's fucking three sheets. He's fucking 4 sheets into the fucking wind. He can barely fucking walk.
I think they kicked him
out of the fucking bada bing down the corner there. You know what I'm talking about there.
I thought he was at brunch, being a brunch skag with the fig wife. And then he's at a strip club, or no, he's at Wet Dreams thinking he's sucking on dongs and like fake clits and shit in Mike Vannucci's shop.
Come pick this fucking guy up. He's talking about fucking he's supposed to be hanging out with Chew. I don't know what's going on, forget about it, but just get over here and pick this fucking mosh bone up, will you, please?
Yep. On my way.
God damn it. Nice seeing you, fellas. Have a great fucking time. Remember, Mike Vannucci. down here at Wild Dreams in Vallejo. Come down and pick up something other than dicks, because Cobra can't fucking bring me any. Maron.
Maron. Exactly. Wow.
Maromi.
That's some shit there.
Bangago. Bangago, whatever.
Bangago, you, whatever.
Yeah. Bafango.
Bafango, that's it.
Yeah.
You know, and then you like rub the chin a little bit. Flip it. Bafango.
Yeah.
I've been watching that. I turned the Fig Wife onto it. I've seen some of the episodes, but we're almost done with the first season of, what's it called? The Sylvester Stallone Tulsa King.
I watched a little bit of that with the wife. It's all right.
It's good. I like it. Like, he actually has some decent acting in it, man. And he's a badass. Really? Like, I don't see him being a mob guy, you know, at all. And then I watched this show. I'm like, okay, all right. I can see it. He does a pretty decent job. I'm like, all right.
He's a good actor in this one movie. He acts very well. I think it's called Copland.
Oh, I love Copland. Yeah. I remember Copland.
Where he's a sheriff that's kind of half deaf.
Yeah.
Because he saved the girl and all that old shit.
Yeah, I remember Copland. It came out in like 96, 97, something like that.
That's a good movie and he acts really good in it.
Yeah. He also,
and there's a lot of great actors in that movie.
They also don't change his height in that. Like, he is a little guy. In Tulsa King, they make him like he's super fucking tall. Like, he's standing on boxes and crates and shit, you know, in every scene. He's like a huge-ass dude, and you're like, I know Sylvester Stallone. He's tiny.
I need my stilts for this scene.
My eyebrows don't move anymore. I'm surgically embedded.
I'm 80,000 years old, and I still look pretty damn good. How about you, Joe Biden? I'm a little younger than you, but I poop my pants.
I don't know what you're trying to say. Taco Bell. Well, look, I think we did it, and there's only one thing you can do after drinking a bunch of 211s, and that's kick the dust up and go buy some more 211s.
Kick the dust up.
Yeah.
Then you got to go find a field or a park or something you can go party in, because your parents ain't letting you party at home. So
all week long, it's a farm in town. They're making them.
Reminds me of when we were camping.
I know. I'm the only person who had 300 songs in their playlist camping, so the same songs would come on constantly. So what's the soundtrack?
And then Charlie shows up with this shit.
Yeah. Charlie shows up with hella country rap. Hella.
Yeah. He fucks with the country rap hard.
Yeah.
Because he's keeping it hood, but yet keeping it wood.
Hoodwood.
Yeah. Woodhood.
Into a party. They're going to turn this cornfield and, like, they're going to shit everywhere. Turning it into a giant fucking potty.
Yeah. I'm inviting my cousin over this weekend.
Oh, you're going to get laid. You're going to make some babies.
We gonna watch House of Dragons, so she won't think there ain't nothing wrong with it.
Although I don't remember seeing a boob in House of Dragons, all I see is wiener.
It's a dong, yeah.
It's just wiener, wiener, wiener,
wiener, wiener, wiener, wiener.
Right. No boobs, no butt sex, nothing. Just nipple sucking like a baby and wiener.
I saw my auntie breastfeeding my cousin.
There's a lot of breastfeeding going on in shows, because in The Boys, Homelander loves breast milk and is constantly like orgasming to breast milk and sucking on people's tits. And this one superhero girl, she squeezes her breast and it just like busts all over his face.
He just loves it.
Oh yeah. It's very uncomfortable.
Right. That show is very uncomfortable.
Yes, it is. We don't say goodbye. We say good journey. Just follow me.
me down. You left me with my cousin. You'll be glad you did. All I had was $8. We go way out where there ain't nobody.
We turn this cornfield into a pot. And remember, drink responsibly, but also buy more 211 so that I don't have to.
Don't say goodbye. Say good journey.
There's an old attorney saying, live the journey, for every destiny is but a doorway to another.